Hello and welcome to the Rhythm and Roots Show with Rohan and Al of the Dublin City Rounders, your weekly dose of ragtime, music hall, bluegrass, country blues, early jazz, western swing, and more. We've got live sessions and interviews with guests local and around the world recorded at Beardfire Studio, Dublin, Ireland. Be sure to like Rhythm and Roots on Facebook, catch up with the podcast on Spreaker.com, and don't forget you can become a Rhythm and Roots Patreon patron today. Now enjoy the show. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. You're all very welcome to Rhythm and Roots. Here with me, Rohan and Al.
Me.
As Al. Do you want to give them a toot? That was Al tooting his ocarina.
It sure was.
Yes, you might. We'll probably hear a lot of that during the show.
Yeah, we're going to have to make up little jingles for different parts of the show.
Current obsession. We've got a great show for you here on Rhythm and Roots this time. We've got an excellent, wonderfully talented guest later in the program. Patricia Lalor is going to be joining us for a couple of live tunes and a chash. We've also got some music from Skinner and Twit, people who we are always playing on the show because they're good lads and ladies all around, called The Wedding Song. They're getting married and they've made up a song for their wedding, their own wedding song, which is pretty special.
He's going to play it at their wedding, though.
Well, apparently there's going to be four different renditions of the song played at the wedding.
Oh.
And they might play. I don't know the full details, but apparently that's what I've heard. So we'll be hearing a little bit about that later on. And also we've got, we're going to shoot back to a recording that we did with the Remedy Club when they were in studio with us a little while ago, because they got a gig coming up that we're going to chat about later as well. But first, let's hear some sweet old-timey tunes. Let's get things kicked off with Roy Newman and his boys. This is A Hard Man Is Good to Find. A good man is hard to find.
Found some other gal, and then you raise, you even praise, see him lying in his grave. If your man is nice, take my advice. Hug him every morning, kiss him every night, give him plenty of love and babe, treat him right. Cause a good man nowadays hard to find. Thank you.
Was the Tweedy Brothers there with Dance All Night With a Bottle.
Good advice, I guess.
I don't know about that. It's I suppose if you were a really good dancer, you could make it work, but otherwise it would probably look a little bit stupid. Speaking of things that aren't stupid, next up we've got the Skinner and Twitch, The Wedding Song. So like I said, this is a song that that Skinner and Twitch are going to be, well, they've written for their own wedding. They're getting married on New Year's Eve, which is, I guess, a good idea. The resolution is fairly apparent. Be together forever, I suppose, would be the idea there.
And they'll have already been together a year in, like, a few hours.
Yeah, exactly. They got married 2018, and it's already 2019. They already got married a year ago. Very clever to add some artificial longevity or longness is the word.
I mean, longevity is the word. You just corrected it to an incorrect word.
I incorrected myself. Steve has written this song to celebrate their marriage in a medieval castle, and the song will be played four times, like I said, in different arrangements on the wedding day.
But we're only going to play it once on the show.
Oh, are we? I thought we were going to play it four times. No, we're going to play it once on the show. So do enjoy our Skinner and Twitch's The Wedding Song.
Here beside the greenwood tree, so deep beneath the sky, lost in love eternally, that's weaving you and I.
As the planets spin and turn and paint the centuries, we live our lives, grow and learn, and now I marry thee. For this is a welding wedding song, where two together is fine and strong. Here's to a life that's mad and long, for this is a wedding song. Promise to be always true, my words are always real. Each day I build my dreams with you and tell you how I feel.
I vow to always stay with you through better and through worse, and share the joy each day with you, the magic of the universe.
For this is a welding wedding song, where two together is fine and strong. Here's to a life that's mad and long, for this is a wedding song. This is a welding wedding song, where two together is fine and strong. Here's to a life that's mad and long, for this is a wedding song. Living beings upon the earth that breathe and eat and play, all living things of beauty's birth can join us here today.
Mountains, forests, desert, sea, the moon and stars so bright can join the dance with you and me upon this special night.
Here beside the greenwood tree, so deep beneath the sky, join us in our merry spree and sing with you and I. For this is a welding wedding song, where two together is fine and strong. Here's to a life that's mad and long, for this is a wedding song. This is a welding wedding song, where two together is fine and strong. Here's to a life that's mad and long, for this is a wedding song.
A girl, she works in the white folk yard. She brings me meal, I swear she brings me love. She brings me meal, honey, she brings me lard. She brings me everything, honey, that a girl can see. Lord of Otterville Circus right at Kingstown. They got a sense of looking nice and brown. They didn't know it was against the law for the monkeys to stop at a 5 cent store. Well, just around the corner, just a minute too late. Another one standing at the big back gate. I'm simply wild about my good cocaine. I stood in my corner, hey, hey. Here comes Sal with a note all tow. Doctor said she couldn't smell no more. Lord, run the doctor, ring the bell, the women in alley. I'm simply wild about my good cocaine. Furniture man came to my house once late Sunday morning. Asked me was my wife at home. Said she'd long been gone. Backed his wagon up to my door. Took everything I had. He carried it back to the furniture store. Honey, I did feel sad. What in the world has any man got now messing with the furniture man? Got no dough, stand for show, certainly will back you back. Take everything from a nursery plate, from a skillet to a frying pan. If there ever was a devil boss without any harness, been a furniture man. I hear you, mama, hey, hey. Here comes Sal with an old auto. Doctor said you couldn't smell no more. Lord, go, doctor, ring the bell, women in alley. I'm simply wild about my good cocaine. A lot of babies in the cradle in New Orleans. The doctor kept a whip until the baby got mean. Doctor whip until the baby got slow. Mama said she couldn't smell no more. Lord, go, doctor, ring the bell, the women in the alley. I'm simply wild about my good cocaine.
About my good cocaine. Woo! That was Dick Justice there with Cocaine. it's a song about cocaine. Of course, do not do drugs, kids at home. It will only lead to trouble and strife. I think the strongest.
And don't do drugs anywhere else either, kids.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, good point. well corrected there. Strongest drug myself and Al partake of is sweet, sweet coffee. And if you listen carefully, you're about to hear me drink a cup of coffee. Here we go. Let's see how this sounds on radio.
He's drinking it. It's about halfway down the cup now. Let's see if he can continue. Oh, he's almost at the bottom. One final gulp and we're done.
That was good. Good coffee. That's all you need, ladies and gentlemen. That's the hardest stuff. Okay, Patricia Lalor. What can we say? She's 13 years old. She's absolutely amazing. And it was a real pleasure to get her into the studio with her fabulous mum, Mary, taking some photos and supporting her wonderfully throughout the whole experience. So it's our pleasure, I suppose, to give a radio debut to Patricia. The first song we're going to hear is one of her original compositions, and myself and Al joined her on double bass and guitar. So without any further ado, do enjoy Patricia Lalor with Regret.
You regret it. I can see it in your eyes. Think I couldn't look past your disguise. But you chose not to listen. You chose the same as everyone else. I'd regret it, but clearly that's not the case. Now you're stuck with dreaming of being in a different place.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're all very welcome back to Rhythm and Roots with me, Rohan Healy, and Al is around somewhere.
Here I am.
Al's, Al's in a well or something. But it's our absolute pleasure and privilege to be joined in the studio today by one Patricia Lalor. Hello.
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 It's good to be here.
Excellent. Well, I'm glad to hear that because otherwise it would be really awkward.
Yep, it would be. Okay.
So for those listening at home, and particularly considering we will have already heard one of your live tunes earlier in the show, one thing that will probably strike people who have heard the earlier song is your age. Let's get that over with. You're 13 years old?
13, but I wrote the song when I was 12. Not to brag, but
not to brag. Right. Thanks. Thanks. You know, you're making me feel really good over it. That it is. It's unbelievable though. Like I did. I came across your stuff online. It was either through. It was one of the other Wexford artists, female artists. If I remember, I'll edit it into the show later on. But I think it was just on Facebook or Instagram, and I was like, oh, what's this? Like, oh my goodness. This is the crazy thing. Not just for your age, you're so your performance is so mature. It's really excellent.
Thank you so much.
So I suppose, how did you get started in music? Did you start singing first or guitar first, or how did that work?
Well, I started guitar, I think, around 3 years ago now. I'm not too sure. But it was kind of like, there's this guitar teacher who was just local right next to my school. And both of my friends went to him, so I was like, you know what, let's try it. So I tried it, and like straight away, I just loved it.
Right, yeah.
And so ever since, it's kind of been like a big thing in my life.
And so in terms of the singing, did you start singing then as a, you know, in order to accompany yourself while you were playing? Or did you enjoy singing before that?
Well, I guess I've always enjoyed music, like whether or not that was like good or bad music. But I always enjoyed it. So yeah. I guess it was just natural to like sing. Yeah. Yeah, I guess.
Well, that's phenomenal because it's you know, I was talking to yourself and your mother before. Your mother's from the United States. Mm-hmm. Did you are you 100%? Were you born in Ireland or did you live in the States ever or anything like that?
No, I was born in Ireland. I do visit the States, but like I was like, born here. You know, as you do on vacation.
Yeah, and I mean, like, what's it been like having that family connection in America? Has it influenced the kind of music you like?
100%. Yeah, definitely by my mom. Mm. Yeah, if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have known, like, I'd say half the music artists that I listen to now, so which is definitely a benefit to have her in my life.
Yeah, yeah.
Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, excellent, excellent. Well, he's getting some props over there. So in terms of those artists that you are inspired by, say overall, like, because there's the kind of artists you might be listening to at the moment, which we'll talk about in a minute, but overall, what would be kind of your top three or four influential artists that you've always found important?
Right. Well, it's funny because I make music, but I don't really like listen to the music that I like write, like the kind of sound. I really like Radiohead, and I write like nothing like Radiohead. Bon Iver. I love Bon Iver. Yeah. He's really good. Florence and the Machine. I went to her concert once, and she was amazing. And I say those are like the top three.
Yeah, but that's great.
Really, really like.
That's nice, and it's kind of diverse. As well, you know, because I think as someone who's writing songs or you know, developing as an artist, you can get caught kind of in a genre. Whereas right. I think it's important to listen, even if your music doesn't necessarily reflect it. Like, it's like myself and my brother there, that the band we play in the most at the moment, the Dublin City Rounders, is like a kind of ragtime old blues kind of thing. But like, we love punk and metal and classical and everything. You know, there's something to take from. There's good music in just about every genre, you know. And right. It's cool that you've got that at such a young age, that appreciation. And in terms of what you're listening to at the moment, what's on your Spotify playlist?
Oh, lots of things.
Okay.
I'm probably going to blank out on most of them.
Right, yeah.
But I really like Rex Orange County. I think they're really good. I don't know. I guess it's just a mix of a lot of things. Like, I'm discovering new artists, and I'm kind of just like, in between that, like Clario, I think her name is
Clario.
Clario. I'm
gonna
not
to,
sure.
You're gonna have to tell me.
It.
Yeah, I'm gonna write
this
down.
She's really
later.
New to my playlist.
Okay,
and all.
Excellent.
And just like things like that, the kind of Yeah, I don't know.
Have you heard that guy? Alex is probably sick of me telling people about it. It's just got, from a production standpoint, it's really interesting. A guy called, I think it's Novo Amor.
Yes, yeah. He sounds exactly like Bon Iver.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
Very, very kind of, dreamy, ambient, cinematic kind of sounds. And, I just think, it's probably not something you could listen to all the time, but it's such a, so atmospheric and so cool, you know.
Yes, I agree. I love his music.
So, in terms of live performance and stuff, I think you did... I was having a look on the Facebook preparing for the show. You did a show at kind of like a school event recently or something like that?
Oh yeah, it was my school's open day and the music teacher decided to just like put me in.
Awesome.
And it was a laid back kind of thing where it was just music in the background, but I really enjoyed it.
That's awesome. That's great. Because I think like, just to have that kind of experience where you have to perform in front of people, you know?
Right, yeah.
It just immediately kind of breaks the ice and knocks that... that anxiety off, you know.
Definitely.
And it's kind of weird though, like, you know, there's a lot of artists, like I know Elvis Presley, apparently he had stage fright like his entire life.
Really?
Yeah, he like never got over it. And
he'd come out. That's probably gonna be me. I'm like always nervous for everything.
Do you find that? Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Oh really? Well, yeah. I tell you what, it doesn't come across in your performances as well. I wouldn't have known. So you're very good at managing it. and in terms of things coming up, obviously, you know, you've got to balance your family life, school life, all that kind of stuff, but what do you see for yourself? Like, is the idea you want to do perform live some more, write, record? What's the plan?
Well, for right now, I definitely want to keep gigging. I think I just love gigging, because like, as nerve-wracking as it is, like, afterwards, it's just, like, the best feeling. That's if it's a good performance. But, like, afterwards, it's just the best feeling, and I really want to get to know more gigs, because I feel like I don't have a lot of connections yet.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
I'm just starting out, so I don't know.
I get this 13-year-old here telling me, I don't have many connections. I'm like, listen, it takes time, you know?
Yeah.
You're way ahead. Relax. It's all good. It absolutely, like, I think in any business, but particularly the music business, it is very often, you know, you have to have the talent, you have to have good songs, you have to have something interesting that you're doing, but you also have to build that network over years very often, you know.
Right.
But it's great. It's great that you're, I'm so jealous. I'm just thinking, like, God, you know, starting at around 11, 12 is such a great age to get into music, but particularly when you've got, a talent for it. And your songs are really mature as well. Like, if you played it to me, I'd be like, oh, that's just a good song.
Right.
It's not a good song because whatever, you know, so.
That's really nice. Thank you.
Well, listen, I would like to thank you so much for taking the time and coming on the show.
Oh, my God. Like, no problem. I honestly enjoyed it so much. This is the best.
Excellent. It's great. To be able to give you your first time on radio too, which is awesome. It won't be the last, I am sure, that people will hear of Patricia Lalor on the radio. People who want to kind of find your stuff, what's the best way? Facebook, Instagram, YouTube?
Yeah, I would definitely... Well, yeah, the three of those things,
right.
Honestly.
Just searching those things.
YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram.
Yeah.
On Instagram, I'm Patricia Lalor Sings, and I just kind of started that Instagram account. Facebook is the same, and YouTube, just look up Patricia Lalor. You should find me.
The cockiness on that face. You should have seen that. But it is true. That's probably the network you've been on the longest, and you've got quite a few videos up, which is great. And it's great motivation as well, I think, when you get that kind of that public feedback as well to keep improving and keep developing yourself.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, I think... I'm going to sound like a total grandpa here, but like back in my day, before the internet was as kind of accessible and what it is now, you had no idea if what you were doing in your bedroom was gonna, you know, really strike people in that way, you know?
Right.
So it's great that you've got the YouTube to kind of
keep
you going. Exactly. Yeah. You know? But yeah, and then the Instagram and the Facebook are a bit newer. And just for people wondering, it's Patricia, P-A-T-R-I-C-I-A.
Mm-hmm.
Lalor is L-A-L-A. L-A-L-O-R? What? I got lost.
It's L-A-L-O-R, no W.
L-A-L-O-R, no W, ladies and gentlemen. Excellent. I got a bit tripped up there, but I got there in the end. So we're going to lead out on a cover rendition of Hozier's Take Me to Church. But before I let you go, is there anything you want to say about the song we heard earlier? It's called Regret? Regret.
Yeah.
Singular, not singular. Plural. Excellent. How? Anything about the lyrics or how the music came to you? Or is there some story there, or is it just like a bunch of stuff?
Well, I had been messing around with chords for a while. Like, I would show my mom. I remember sitting in the sitting room, like, I need to, like, get a song with this. But, like, I couldn't really find the words. And I guess just experience happens. And
Yeah. Kinda... And they come to you sometimes as well. And sometimes it's bizarre as well. Like, I've had the experience of writing songs at a certain time, and you think, oh, that doesn't make any sense. And then, like, later in life, it's like, oh, that actually makes a lot of sense. So, right. That's the last thing I'm going to say is just, it's cool to hear, dominant sevenths and things like that in songs that aren't just the old same old chords, which is really nice to hear those kind of jazzy sounds as well. Yeah. Well, listen, thank you so much, Patricia, for taking the time and coming in.
Thank you.
And we'll see you again soon. This is Patricia Lawler with Al joining her on the bass for Hozier's Take Me to Church.
My love has got humor. She's a giggle at a funeral. Knows everybody's disapproval. Should've worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's a true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak. Fresh poison each week. We were born sick. Heard them saying, my love offers no absolute. She tells me worship in the bedroom. The only heaven I'll be sent to is when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Command me to be well. Church, I worship like a dog at the shrine of your lies. Tell you my sins and you can sharpen your knife. I believe a death is dark. Good God, let me give you my life. If I'm a pagan of the good times, to keep my love in the sunlight, to keep the goddess on my side. She demands a sacrifice to drain the whole sea. Something shiny, something meaty for the main course. That's a fine looking high horse. What you got in the stable? She demands a faithful. That looks tasty, that looks plenty. This is hungry wars. Take me to church, I worship like a dog. Shrine of your life. Tell you my sins and you can sharpen your knife. I believe a death is dark. Good God, let me give you my life. Take me to church, I worship like a dog at the shrine of your lies. I'll tell you my sins and you can sharpen your knife. I believe a death is dark. Good God, let me give you my life. There is no sweeter innocence than our gentle sin. In this madness and soil of a sad earthly scene, only then I am human, only then I am clean. and sharp and get knife. Believe or death is death. Good God, let me give you my life. Take me to church, I'll worship like a dog at the shrine of your lies. I'll tell you my sins and you can sharp and get knife. I believe or death is death. Good God, let me give you my life.
Patricia Lalor there with her rendition of Take Me to Church. Definitely one to keep an eye on. Incredibly talented young lady there. Very much looking forward to seeing what comes from her in the future and indeed the present. I mean, she's already active. In fact, there's a gig coming up on the 8th of December at the Art Cafe in Dublin, Frenchman's Lane. Myself and Al, the Dublin City Rounders, will be playing there from about, what do we do, like 6:30 to 8:30 kind of thing.
Yeah.
And Patricia's going to come and play a few tunes live at the Art Cafe as well. So if you do find yourself around town, do pop into the Art Cafe, Frenchman's Lane in Dublin on Saturday, the 8th of December for the Dublin City Rounders.
They also have pizza.
They have pizza. They got chimkins. They've got everything you need.
What do they have?
Chimkins. They've got all sorts of delicious farmyard friends on the table. And I presume vegetarian options
Probably, as well.
So we're going to hear a couple more old-timey tunes. Let's kick things off with a little bit of Frank Hutchison. This is the Frank Hutchison song, Back in My Hometown. We'll be right back.
The captain called up the volunteers, I shouldered up my gun. First Spaniard that I seen, I dropped my gun and run. But I was fighting for this battleship of Maine. I was fighting in this great war with Spain. Fighting for the battleship of Maine. Oh, get back, Spain, I don't know your name. I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. Marched out on the battlefield, I fell upon my knees. First thing my eyes fell on was a great big pot of beer. But I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. The peers, they were greasy, meat it was fat. The rest fought the Spaniards, but I was fighting that. While I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. It's all about this golden ring. All about this battleship of Maine. Oh, get back, Spain, I don't own your name. I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. The blood, it was running, I was running too. You might be good exercise and nothing else to do. While I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. The captain asked me why I run, was I afraid to die? Told him the reason that I run, because I couldn't fly. But I was fighting for this battleship of Maine. It's all about this golden ring. All about this battleship of Maine. Oh, get back, Spain, I don't own your name. I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. I marched round the Bubee, all back to Spain. The shot fall around me just like a shower of rain. While I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. I marched round the Bubee, I thought I'd lose my life. Before I go to war again, I'd send my darling wife to fight for this battleship of Maine. It's all about this golden ring. All about this battleship of Maine. Oh, get back, Spain, I don't own your name. I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine. You ought to see the boat, she come around the bend. She loaded down with American men, ready for war. Honey, baby, sure as you come. Young dodge behind the window, turn behind the door. But you can't dodge American Long 44s while I'm fighting for this battleship of Maine.
As Wilmer Watts there with the fighting in the War of Spain. Fighting in the War of Spain, is that what it's called? In the War of Spain, yes.
Yeah.
I just checked my list there. Fighting in the War of Spain is the name of that song. Next up, we're going to hear the Remedy Club. Remedy Club, great husband and wife Americana duo. Excellent, excellent musicians. We had the pleasure of performing with them not too long ago at the Eastside Tavern a little while ago, it was about a month ago or something now, wasn't it? But before
and then you
that,
went straight home and learned how to do harmonics really good on guitar because you
yeah,
saw him do it
was once. I don't know if it was harmonics or something, but yeah, I stole a lot of his ideas. KJ McAvoy there, excellent, excellent guitarist, and the envy of many guitarists, including myself. But of course, we had the pleasure of having them in the studio not too long before that show as well. We did a live video and live rendition of their song Big Old Fancy. They've got a show coming up on the 19th of... sorry, what am I saying? At the 19th hole is the name of the place in Clonmel. It's the 17th of December.
That's
is
confusing.
The name. It's very confusing, isn't it? At the 19th. 19th hole, Irish Town, Clonmel, Remedy Club. They're playing on the 17th of December. Tickets are €15. Doors are 7 p.m. So do not miss them if you find yourself out Clonmel Way on the 17th of December. That is the Remedy Club. And to get you a little bit hyped for that show, here is our rendition with the Remedy Club of Big Old Fancy.
Mm-hmm. big old fancy house, big old fancy life, big old fancy lady sitting by my side. Big old fancy driveway, big old fancy car, big old fancy drinks lined up at the bar. I've been throwing that dice, watching it roll. Now that big old fancy life has got me in a hole. Big old fancy lawyers got them on speed dial. Keep me out of trouble, keep me in the style, to which I am accustomed, maybe not for long. Somebody might have smelled that something rotten's going on. I've been throwing that dice, watching it roll. Now that big old fancy life has got me in a hole. Yes, it has. Big old fancy suitcase, count my fancy clothes. I like to dress real fancy just so everybody knows how important I've become, what my money can buy. But I never stop to wonder, no, I never even ask why. I've been throwing that dice, I've been watching it roll. Now that big old fancy life has got me in a hole. Yes, it has. Big old fancy, big old fancy life. Jet plane, carry me around the world. I got it loaded up with champagne, cocktails and girls, catering to my every whim. They're at my beck and call, but I guess I took my big old greedy eyes off the ball. Cause I've been throwing that dice, I've been watching it roll. Now that big old fancy life has got me in a hole. Yes, it has. Big old fancy, fancy life, big old fancy, big old fancy life, big old fancy, big old fancy life, big old fancy, big old fancy life has got me down in the.
The excellent Remedy Club there with Big Old Fancy. We've got time for one more tune, ladies and gentlemen, so I'd like to thank you very, very much for tuning in, enjoying the program. Do catch us again next week for another excellent show. One more little plug to do as well is on the 9th of December, coming up Sunday the 9th of December, we're starting the very first Rhythm and Lutes.
Rhythm and Lutes.
I don't know if there's going to be any lutes.
We don't
there.
Have any lute players there this time, but we might next time.
In future, and then it'll be the Rhythm and Lutes show. Rhythm and Roots Live. We've got a great lineup. Fiona O'Farrell, Andrea Booth, Runa, Kerry Fearon, and Wilbury, as well as us, the Dublin City Rams. We're all going to be playing some hopefully excellent live music there at Napper Tandy's brand new venue upstairs in Chambers Pub.
We didn't make it up.
Marion's
Green.
It
exists.
It's a real place. It is being created at the moment. But if you know Chambers or Marcel's there on Marion Row in Dublin, just near the Stephen's Green, that's where it's going to be. So Sunday, the 9th of December, free entry. Put it in the diaries. Lots of really good music. And the show will be recorded live as well for the program.
So if you come down and scream and clap really loud, you might end up on Rhythm and Roots.
You may end up on Rhythm and Roots and be the envy of all your pals. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for listening to the program tonight. We'll catch you in 1 week's time. And until then, do enjoy this Charlie Poole tune. This is It's Moving Day. So from myself and...
myself.
Do you want to give him one more toot before you say
yeah,
goodnight?
Yeah, sure. A farewell toot. It sounded kind of ominous, but...
That was fairly ominous, wasn't it? But hopefully
it was
everyone...
like the end.
Makes it home. Oh, I see, yes. A cliffhanger. Hmm. Well, tune in next time to see if that little scale resolves onto its root. Anyway, that was Al with blowing on his ocarina there, as he always does. And from us, it's a good night. This is Charlie Poole with It's Movin' Day, and we'll see you next week. Good night. Bye.
Come home, keep my honey from the honeycomb. He'll have money, cause he told me so this morning. He called this moving day, moving day. I ripped the carpet up off the floor, load you all stove and out the door. Cause moving day, packy bitch will get away. If you spend ever since, you can live out in a tent. It's moving day. Get away. If you spend every cent, you can live out in a tent. It's moving.